is the Rodgers Allegiant 677. I'm going to play the sounds of a few stops individually. Then I'll play a little bit, just some random playing with the combinations. This is the principal 8 on the great. I'm going to turn that reverb down. Okay, no reverb now. So you can hear the pure tone better. Then the 8-foot roar flute. Principal 8, add the octave 4, super octave 2, and the mixture. Then I'll pull out the roar flute 8, 4-foot flute, and the quint flute. The trumpet on the great. Here is the clarion on the great. Here is the chime on the great. On the swell, there is a string celeste. There is a Borden 8-foot. That's a distinctively different flute from this roar flute on the great. There's the great swell. Much airier and chiffier flute up there. This is the swell flute chorus 8, 4, and 2. Gagan principle on the swell. Adding the precedent 4 and the plain G. Here is the principal chorus on the great and the swell. And then I'll couple them together. The principal 16, it expresses with the great shoe, then the sub bass 16. Also have an octave 8, bedecked 8, curl bass 4, and a sound of 16. Full pedal sounds like this. Now I have some full organ registrations This is principles. There's an 8-foot flute in there also, and the 16-foot pedals. Sounds like this. Sound. Now the organ has digital reverb, which is very nice, and I can turn that on and adjust the level of it, and you can see how much this adds. This is about where I set it for practice. Might not need that much in a room that actually has some live reverb. Okay, I will go back to a reedless full organ and just play another chorus. What it sounds like.